Right, good morning, grade 12s. This is one of the promised lessons on financial maths. Okay, cool. So I'm going to give you quite a number of these lessons on financial maths as promised. Okay, so look at what I have here on the screen is, of course, revision of grade 11 work. Right, so let's start there to see how much you still remember of grade 11. So remember, these are very short videos until we get to the grade 12 work, and then I can again zoom the grade 12 work with you. So let's see. Of course, way back in grade 8, you started learning about simple and compound interest. That's just a quick revision. So simple interest is used, right? Interest is calculated as a percentage of the original amount invested or borrowed. So you either invest or you can borrow. If you invest, you will get money back. If you borrow, you pay money back, isn't it? So the following formula is used to do the calculations where simple interest is concerned. A equals to P, 1 plus IN. I'm sure you still remember that one. Compound interest is used, is interest is added after every year. And again, here, you can either borrow money, right, or you can invest. Again, it's the same thing. You borrow the money or you invest the money. If you borrow, you're going to pay back. If you invest, of course, you will get money back. And the formula is AP plus I to the power N. Let's again see what does each symbol mean. A, of course, is the final amount. The answer, in other words, the final amount you're looking for. P, of course, is the principal or initial amount you're starting with. I is the interest rate. And remember, where's I coming from? I is R over 100. The rate divided by 100, that is I. Now, of course, N is the number of periods. Simple interest, people, as you can see, is linear. Right? It is a straight line, it's linear, so it's not exponential. Where compound is exponential, so therefore it will be a curve. That is why it is exponential, it's a curve. Interest is not always calculated annually, remember that. It can also be calculated monthly, quarterly, half yearly. That you must also remember. So let's look at the first example. David invests 50,000 at 8% per annum compound interest. What will this money, will his money grow to in 5 years if interest is compounded annually, quarterly, monthly? Now, when you approach a financial problem, people always ask yourself, is it simple or compound? Those are the first two questions. If they say compounded, then you know it is compound, then you know exactly which formula to choose. Right. And what is given? 50,000 is your principal amount. 8% is your interest rate. It's not I yet. Where we must first divide 8 by 100. And of course, the time is 5 years. So if you do it, right, there's the first one. Now, if this is annually, then remember, I will be your, remember your interest rate I said early on, your 8%. Your 8% divided by 100, so don't forget. So 8 divided by 100 gives you 0,08. And of course, N is 5. So this is annually. So it's just a straightforward substitution. However, if it becomes quarterly, now remember there are 4 quarters in a year. So that 8% must be shared over 4 quarters. That is why that 0,8 must be divided by 4, because it must be shared over 4 quarters. And of course, the 5 becomes now 5 times 4. So remember, you increase the time now. So therefore, 5 times 4. Dear guys, and the next one, right here, I think it was half yearly. Let me just check. Is C half yearly? Right, let's see. No, C is monthly. So if it's monthly, then of course, you know, there's 12 months in a year. So your 0,8 must be shared by 12. So it's divided by 12. And of course, your 5 years will increase 12 times because there's 12 months in a year. So it's 5 times 12 is 60. And there you are. There's your answer. Right. Next example. Tulani borrows 2,000 rand with the agreement that you will pay back 3,000 exactly 2 years from now. Calculate the interest rate charged per annum compounded monthly. Again, is it simple or compound? It is compound. Now I know which formula to choose. It's compound. Secondly, what is given? 2,000 is your principal amount. Ah, but 3,000 is the final amount. Oh, so principal and final is given. Time is given. What is missing? The interest rate. So they were, there's your formula substitute. So I is then not known. Is it clear, guys? This is annually. So therefore, there's no divide by 4 or divide by 2. It's annually. Substitute. Divide both sides by 2,000. Get rid of the exponent 24. What's the inverse? The 24th root, isn't it? On both sides. Then you take the 1 over. So it's all calculated work. So people, please remember, you must first make I the subject before you use the calculator. Because if you start to divide here too early, you're going to round off prematurely, and that is not a good idea. So you don't round off before the time. Now, that is not the answer, people. We want the interest rate. This is I. Remember, where's I coming from? It's divided by 100, so I'll have to take it back. But before I do that, remember, this is month. So interest rate is compounded monthly. The rate obtained from the formula is a monthly rate. Right. So therefore, you must first multiply that value by 12, right, to get 0.2045. And then, of course, divide times 100 to convert to percentage. And there you are, 20.45. But cool, guys, that is an introduction to financial maths, grade 11 stuff. The next video, I'll take it further. Thank you.